For this one, we've been given OF2, and it's a little bit more challenging, but not too much. We'll have a lot of valence electrons, it looks like. So let's count them. Our first step is to count the valence electrons. And for that, we need a periodic table. And looks like oxygen is over here, and that's in group 16 or 6. So that has 6 valence electrons. And then fluorine right here is in group 7 or 17. So fluorine has 7 valence electrons. But there are 2 fluorines. So if we add 6 plus, well, 7 times 2 is 14 plus 6, that should give me 20 total valence electrons to work with. Here they want us to put the least electronegative at the center. Fluorine, it turns out, is the most electronegative. So whatever's further away from fluorine, we're going to put at the center. And we're talking about oxygen here. So oxygen's over here. It's still pretty electronegative, but fluorine's the most. Oxygen is less. So let's put oxygen at the center, and then we can just put the fluorines on either side. That works. So we did that step. We add 2 electrons between each bond, and then we put the remaining electrons around the atoms to fulfill the octet. So I'll start out with the central atom. So I've used 8, which means I need to get 20 total. So 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. I used up all my electrons. Let's see what we got. Check and make sure we're right here. We got an octet for oxygen, and both fluorines have octets. So we've satisfied the octet rule, and these chemicals, these atoms, are now bonded together, so they're going to stay together, and they're much more stable because they're sharing electrons to obtain a full outer shell or an octet.